Hey guys, all right, week two in the books of Lift More. So I have the coveted workout calendar and the weight progression tracker sheet. I want to talk about those real quickly. You have to track. So my tip of week two is track. You don't know what to do if you don't know where you were. So you want to be able to push the envelope on these workouts, maximizing right from the get-go. So week one, you might be figuring some things out. Hopefully you're adjusting mid-sets to go up or down if needed. Well, in week two is a little bit of a curveball because he throws in, my dog coming down the stairs. He throws in, the workouts are the same as far as which body parts you're doing which day, but he changes the formats. So the days where you're doing four moves, you might be doing just two now. So you can up the weight, hopefully, in those. And then the ones you did two, now you're doing four, you might have to cut it back a little bit. What's up, Bax? You might have to cut it back or try to maintain. But again, it's really important to track. It's really important to write down for each set, you know, did I hold that weight for each one? Did I have to go down? Did I have to go up? Whatever it may be. And really pushing the envelope of the reps that he's asking for and making sure that you're like really gassed towards the end of that. I think that's super important. You want to maximize. You're trying to lift more to get more results. Okay, so that's that. I'll put these away. I think week two was the excitement of week one burned off a little bit, and I'm like, okay, wow, here we go again. I'm recovered from week one, and now I'm right back into the deep end of the pool. So that I think was. You know, this program I think is definitely going to progress, but you're still pretty deep right away. So just, you know, prepare yourself for that, which leads me into really what the most important thing is here is, aside from the tracking, is that you have to fuel your body. I am using all of the performance line, recover, recharge, and hydrate. So yeah, real important. And on the meal front, I'm definitely more mindful of I'm following that more closely because you have to fuel your body. If you don't fuel your body, it's not going to perform properly. So you want to make sure that you're getting enough calories in. I'm doing a gut protocol, and I love it. So it's very easy to follow for me, and it just keeps me on track, and I'm seeing great results from it. But you might have to increase a little bit. Just be mindful that these are not easy workouts. It's meant to be difficult. It's meant to lift more, right? So you really want to make sure that the fuel is in so you can perform at your best, and then so you'll get the results. Because if you do all the work, so on two fronts, you can have a bad diet, which you can't outwork, or you could be eating well, but not enough and not having the fuel necessary, and both of them are not going to get you the results you're really looking for. And if you're going to do the work, I don't want to throw any of it back, you know? So if you do either of those, it's like doing the workout and throwing part of it away as if you didn't do it. And that's not what I want to do. I want to maximize short as possible, maximum effort, maximum results. Like that's kind of just how I operate. So there's no reason to work out for a long period of time if you're doing it properly. Anyway, so that's it. And I think this program nails that to a T. What else? Depending on your weights, I'll just talk about that real quick and I'll wrap it up, is that depending on your weight selection, you might have like select tech type weights, and changing them might be, you know, we all have dumbbells, but if you're trying to change out a select tech weight, you might have to hit pause to get those weights changed because he's moving so quickly. You know, it's not the end of the world to take the extra 5 seconds, but you know, we don't, so we have to have our weights kind of lined up.
Tip that down. I don't know if you guys can see that down there. Yeah. So, having that is it's very helpful just to pick up the next weight and just be ready. So, know
which moves are coming. He does give you time. He doesn't give you a lot of time, and that's okay. You're not supposed to have a lot of time. So, all right. So that's week two wrap up. I'll put in here. I'll click in some slide in some moves from this week, so you can see one move from each day. Lead me to the magic of the moment.
That's it. I'll see you guys here for next week, week three review. If you haven't seen week one, you can go search that and you can check out my week one review. All right, guys, have a good one. We'll see you.